Good evening. Our big story tonight, drought conditions not seen in decades are sparking major water concerns across the West.
90% of Western states are now officially in a drought, including Arizona. This is a look at how the drought has spread across Arizona since January of this year. That deep maroon color is exceptional drought, and the red is extreme drought.
And just yesterday, a grim milestone. Lake Mead reached its lowest levels since it was filled for the first time more than 80 years ago.
Team 12's Joe Dana explains why it's a red alert for the Southwest.
The drought we're experiencing is part of a 22-year mega drought, one of the worst stretches in centuries, according to scientists. And that means the state will soon have to make do with less river water.
If you want to understand how bad the drought is, look at reservoir levels. This week, Lake Mead recording its lowest levels since the lake was filled in the 1930s. It now stands at just 36% full capacity. The meager water levels means the feds are expected to declare an official shortage of Colorado River water later this summer. And get ready, Arizona will have to give up 17% of its total delivery of Colorado River water starting next year.
There will be hard decisions that have to be made.
Assistant State Climatologist Aaron Saffo says farming and ranching operations in rural Arizona will likely suffer consequences first. Cutting back their share of water could impact the price of food.
It's the law of supply and demand. Obviously, when you don't have the lettuce, it's going to be more expensive. And so those are considerations that that will need to be considered by people that are managing water supply and those other aspects of our economy.
For Arizonans living in big cities and suburbs, water conservation measures may be put in place.
Things that could happen, they might raise the price of water. Cities may ask to conserve water.
Saffo says water conservation technology in new home builds will also be crucial. In response to the prospect Arizona will lose a share of Colorado River water next year, state water leaders releasing a message saying in part, "These reductions are painful, but we are prepared." They add, as we face the prospect of a hotter and drier future, we are confident that with our long history of successful collaboration among our diverse stakeholders, we will continue to find innovative and effective solutions. Two forces, human-caused climate change and drought, soon to usher in a new era of water conservation for the state.
Something else to consider here, when there's less Colorado River water, farms and cities may pump more groundwater. That means underground aquifers, many which have already been impacted by drought, could be depleted further. Joe Dana, 12 News.